for entrance, let us take hymn number 33. Hymn number 33 on page 10.
We are together again, just praising the Lord. We are together again, in one accord. Something good is going to happen. Something good is in store. We are together again, just praising the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, gathered around this altar, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate worthily the sacred mysteries. And therefore, let us acknowledge that we are sinners. And therefore, let us ask for God's pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on us all. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy on us all. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on us all. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy on us all.
We pray today for the soul of Fatima Mischita. May God grant her eternal life and a share in the resurrection of his Son, Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that you are faithful, who rejoice under the patronage of the Most Holy Virgin Mary, may be freed by her motherly intercession from all evils on earth and merit the attainment of eternal joys in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brethren, Christ is proclaimed, and in that I rejoice. Yes, and I will rejoice, for I know that through your prayers and the help of the Spirit of Jesus Christ, this will turn out for my deliverance, as it is my eager expectation and hope that I will not be at all ashamed, but that with full courage now as always, Christ will be honored in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me to live in is Christ, and to die is gain. For I am to live in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me, yet which I shall choose I cannot tell. I am hard pressed between the two. My desire is to depart and be with Christ, for that is far better. But to remain in the flesh is more necessary on your account. Convinced of this, I know that I will remain and continue with you all for your progress and joy in the faith, so that in me you may have ample cause to glory in Christ Jesus because of my coming to you again. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let our response shall be, my soul is thirsting for God, the living God. Can you repeat?
My soul is thirsting for God, the living God.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul is yearning for you, my God. Response,
My soul is thirsting for God, the living God.
My soul is thirsting for God, the living God. When can I enter and appear before the face of God? Response,
My soul is thirsting for God, the living God.
For I would go to the place of your wondrous tent, all the way to the house of God, amid cries of gladness and thanksgiving, the throng keeping joyful festival. Response,
My soul is thirsting for God, the living God.
Kindly stand for the gospel acclamation.
God has spoken to his people. Alleluia, alleluia. And his words are words of wisdom. Alleluia.
Take my yoke upon you, says the Lord, and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart.
God has spoken to his people. Alleluia, alleluia. And his words are words of wisdom. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
One Sabbath, when Jesus went to dine at the house of a ruler of the Pharisees, they were watching him carefully. Now, he told a parable to those who were invited. When he noticed how they chose the places of honor, saying to them, when you are invited by someone to a wedding feast, do not sit down in a place of honor, lest someone more distinguished than you be invited by him. And he who invited you both will come and say to you, give your place to this person. And then you will begin with shame to take the lowest place. But when you are invited, go, and sit in the lowest place, so that when your host comes, he may say to you, "Friend, move up higher." Then you will be honored in the presence of all who sit at table with you. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, today's date is 31st October. This is the last day of the month of October. And as we all know, the month of October is known as the month of the Holy Rosary. Very well, we know the reason why. In this very month, we celebrated two feasts in honor of Mother Mary. We are her children. We love her so much, and she loves us greatly, immensely. On 7th October, we celebrated a feast of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary. This feast was instituted by Pope Pius V. And the reason is, Christians prayed the Holy Rosary and they attained a victory at Lepanto. And much later, this feast was extended throughout the Catholic Church. Then on 13 October, we celebrated the feast of Our Lady of Fatima. That was her last apparition at Fatima to those little shepherd children with a profound message to humanity, and the message was, repent, change your life, and pray the rosary. And that is the reason why throughout this month we have been praying the rosary, the Holy Rosary. My dear brothers and sisters, the rosary is a gospel prayer. The rosary is a biblical prayer. The gospel or the rosary is the compendium, summary of the history of salvation. Imagine the mysteries. We have joyful mysteries, sorrowful mysteries, luminous mysteries. These mysteries were added much later by Saint Pope John Paul II. And glorious mysteries. The joyful mysteries, as you will see, all five are taken from the gospel. It is the incarnation, the focus is on the reality, fact of incarnation. God becoming man. The luminous mysteries talk about important events in the life of Jesus for the salvation of humankind and the gifts that he bestows on us. The last mystery is
the institution of the Holy Eucharist. That is his sacrifice and his sharing of his body and blood as our spiritual food for our nourishment. Then sorrowful mysteries. All five you find in the gospel. And then joyful and glorious mysteries. The first mystery directly taken from the gospel. And the other two, the assumption of Mary, body and soul to heaven, and crowning of Mary as queen of heaven and earth, is done by the church. So, my dear brothers and sisters, we are convinced that this is the history of salvation when we pray the rosary. We say, Hail Mary. This is the greeting of Angel Gabriel to Mother Mary. And in this very greeting, there is also the greeting of Elizabeth. And blessed are you and the fruit of your womb. So it is a biblical prayer. We are reflecting on the mysteries of our salvation. Our Father, we say, what is our Father? Is it a prayer that Jesus taught us? He told us to call God our Father. And we praise God. We say, Holy be your name, your kingdom come. So we want God's power on us. We want God's lordship on us. Give us this day our daily bread. What bread it is? It makes reference to Eucharistic bread, not forgetting our daily needs, our daily food, our accommodation, our shelter, our clothing. And we say that God forgives us. We receive the gift of forgiveness of God. And we also tell God that we will forgive our brothers and sisters. And that is why, my dear brothers and sisters, it was a joy to see so many people till date like this prayer of Mother Mary. And we should, without fail, pray rosary in our families. And during this month, people have been praying. Before COVID, people used to gather at the open places, maybe at the cross, maybe at a small chapel, or at Somudai, and they used to pray the rosary. And that must brought blessings of Mother Mary on all these people, family people. And that is why it was said by Father Peyton, a family that prays together stays together. He was referring to the prayer of the rosary. And even now, during COVID times, there were efforts and attempts in a different manner to pray the rosary, but pray rosary together. What we call by virtual mode. In some somudai, some communities, they connected themselves through these means and prayed the rosary. It will not go unnoticed by Mother Mary. Mother Mary was present at their families, and definitely he will bestow on them the assistance and prayers. And our main prayer during these times is that through the intercession of Mary, we may be freed from COVID, that we may get the best drug or best vaccine, because people are still under the grip of fear and panic of this deadly disease. So let us go to her in faith And today's gospel, just to say, speak one word, is the humility that we must have. And in the life of Mother Mary, this is very much highlighted, her faith and humility to be at the service of others. We need to humble ourselves so that we give time, give our energy to our brothers and sisters. And in the first reading, let us pick up the main idea, what Paul says, it is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. He was one with Christ. It did not happen overnight in his case. He was very much imbued and immersed in the Lord. Jesus, who called him for this great mission to proclaim Jesus' message. Let us thank Jesus. Let us thank God the Father for giving us Mary as an outstanding model of Christian living.
For offertory, let us sing hymn number 128, hymn number 128 on page 35.
Our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look, O Lord, upon the prayers and offerings of your faithful, presented in commemoration of Blessed Mary, the Mother of God, that they may be pleasing to you and may confer on us your help and forgiveness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. for truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord of power and God of might. Heaven and earth are filled with glory. Sing Hosanna evermore. Blessed and holy, blessed and holy. From God on high, raise your voices, sing his glory, praise his name forevermore.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Philip Neri, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters We have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her spouse, Blessed Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
For communion, let us take hymn number 183 on page 56, hymn number 183.
Let us pray. Renewed by the sacrament of salvation, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that we who have honored in veneration the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, may merit to experience in perpetuity the fruits of your redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To mark the end of this month of October dedicated to Mother Mary, we have a special final solemn blessing. Let your response be Amen after each intercession. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary, willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
May you know always and everywhere the protection of her, through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life.
Amen.
May you who have devoutly gathered on this day carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us sing recessional hymn number 220, 220 on page 69.
It's no longer I that liveth, but Christ that liveth in me. It's no longer